Okay, welcome. Could we please stand and remove your cap for our national anthem? Well, good afternoon and welcome to the Algoma Community Band and their Shandy Days concert. First, let me introduce the director of the band, Tom Miller. Let's hear it for Tom. A couple interesting thoughts about the Star Spangled Banner. It was actually a poem. And it was written by Francis Scott Key, who was a 35-year-old lawyer and a poet. This was during the War of 1812, when the United States fought the British Empire. The war was declared over the conscription of U.S. citizens into the Royal Navy and a series of trade restrictions that the U.S. contested as illegal under international law. The war ran from June 18, 1812 to March 23rd of 1815. Peace came after a victory in New Orleans. It was made our national anthem in March of 1931. Our next song is Curtain Call, originally composed by John Wasson for the five brass players and the percussionists of the Dallas Brass. This selection takes on a new life in a concert band arrangement. The song is really a kick. It's a lot of fun. You'll recognize this familiar fast-paced melody. You'll also notice it features lots of percussion, cliches, and false endings. The band loves it, and you will too, especially you brass aficionados in the audience. See if you can tap your toes and keep up with them. Get ready for a curtain call.
Thank you.
Wasn't that fun? By the way, I have some programs in the box. If anybody didn't get a program, you can just come on up and we have some extras in there. Guys and Dolls is a 1950 Broadway musical by Frank Loesser, which is about gangsters, gamblers, and others in the New York underworld fraternity. It ran for 1,200 performances on Broadway and won the Tony Award for Best Musical. In 1951, it was selected as a winner of the Pulitzer Prize for Drama, but because of the writer, Abe Burrows, he had problems with the House Un-American Activities Committee and no prize was awarded. In 1955, Guys and Dolls was made into a film. You'll recognize many of the tunes from the famous musical that include Lady, Luck Be a Lady, Sit Down, You're Rocking the Boat, and A Bushel and a Peck. Here's Guys and Dolls. Thank you. Well, now we're really going to pick up the tempo. Amparito Roca was composed in 1925 by a Spanish musician and composer, Jaime Trexidor, who named it after one of his 12-year-old piano students. This arrangement was adapted by Aubrey Winter in 1935 and is typically played by regimental marching bands around the world. Sit back and enjoy the fun melodies as the band plays Amparito Roca. And if you notice, Tom, I didn't roll any R's. Yes. Okay.
Oh,
Irving Berlin was born in May 1888 and he passed away in September of 1989. He was one of the most prolific American songwriters in history. Berlin was one of the few Tin Pan Alley Broadway songwriters who wrote both the lyrics and the music for his songs. Although he never learned to read music beyond a rudimentary level, he eventually composed more than 3,000 songs, 17 film scores, and 21 Broadway scores. None of our patriotic holidays pass without playing of the stirring songs of Irving Berlin. Here's a collection of Irving Berlin's pieces, Songs for America. Thank you. Serpentina March is an Italian grand march written by Czech composer Julius Fusek in about 1900. Fusek was a bandmaster for the 86th Infantry Regiment in Sarajevo and a prolific composer. He's sometimes known as the Bohemian Fusek. His most famous composition, Entrance of the Gladiators, which is also known as Thunder and Blazes, is a circus march. It's internationally known to almost everyone. Here is a Florentiner march, a fast-paced and fun march you're sure to enjoy. Thank you. One of the most iconic tunes from World War II is the Boogie Woogie Bugle Boy. It was a major hit of the Andrews Sisters. The song was written by Don Ray and Huey Prince and was recorded at Decca's Hollywood Studios on January 2, 1941, nearly a year before the United States entered World War II, but after the start of a peacetime draft to expand the armed forces in anticipation of American involvement. Listen up for the trumpet section in this song. They really rock on this one. Boogie Woogie Bugle Boy. Didn't they do a great job on that? Yeah. You know, when you hear that song, it just makes you recall some of those famous pictures from World War II of our heroes, the servicemen and women that served and gave for their country, and really makes you feel proud. We're going to change the pace for this next one. This is called March Heroic. It was written by Robert Schumann and arranged for concert band by Philip Gordon. I don't have too much text to share on that one, but the band does it the best. Here's March Heroic.
Thank you.
Walter Finlayson was a prolific composer and arranger. He conducted the 300 voice naval chorus and played saxophone and clarinet next to Artie Shaw. The Algoma Community Band is proud to play one of the pieces that he wrote. Our next selection is the Storm King March. Here's one that all of you are going to recognize. This is a theme from New York, New York. It's a theme song from the Martin Scorsese film New York, New York, 1977, composed by John Kander, with lyrics by Fred Ebb. It was written for and performed in the film by Liza Minnelli. It remains one of the best remembered songs about New York City. In 1979, it was recorded by Frank Sinatra and has since become closely associated with him. He occasionally has even performed it live with Liza Minnelli as a duet. Here is a theme from New York, New York.
Thank you.
Even the dog liked this one. Next we have His Honor March, Henry Fillmore. Henry Fillmore was in 1881 to 1956, when he passed away. Was a prolific composer and arranger and a beloved band leader whose music and performances delighted audiences all over. He composed over 250 songs, including 113 marches. His Honor March is just one of his famous marches. Written in 1933, it is a brisk circus march with challenges for all instruments in the band. Here is His Honor March.
Yourself a chair.
Few marches, and I know you've all been waiting for one of these. What would an outdoor concert be without having a polka, right? This polka is straight, and Tom picked this one especially from a Whoopi John collection.
Whoopi D.
The Algoma Community Band invites you to get up and dance. If any of you have some extra energy, feel free. And if you find a spot out there in the sun, but here is the Village Tavern Polka. Well, we certainly have to include a Sousa march in today's concert, and our final selection for today is El Capitan. El Capitan is an operetta in three acts by John Philip Sousa, one of the country's most famous composers. He was best known for his marches, but also composed overtures, suites, dances, and symphonic works. The march from this operetta has become a standard work for brass bands and a crossover into other genres. Most people enjoy Sousa's marches, as we hope you will enjoy El Capitan. But before we get on with this, we'd certainly like that you've been a great audience. Thank you. And those of you sitting in the sun, getting a suntan, we appreciate you sticking around. And certainly, I want to thank you for your support to the community band. So, with that.
Oh, how about a big hand for Kari Wold, our welcome to the club. Thank you.
You're welcome. But thanks so much for your support and for attending. Here is El Capitan March.